Talk.
Off the ball. This is News Talk.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Thursday's Off the Ball. Nathan with you for this evening. And for the next little while, we're going to have a slightly different Off the Ball because I have an exclusive for you. Around 10 years ago, you might remember, Ray Foley and his little producer, JP, they disappeared from Today FM, never to be seen again. What happened to their careers? I'm not quite sure. JP, most people assumed, was living in shame in a cave in Louth, somewhere down the outback of Louth. But I can actually reveal, exclusively, that JP, of Rain JP fame, has actually been producing Off the Ball for the last 5.5 years. And would you believe it, today, his very last day, has finally decided to come on air. So we can all bow down in his presence.
Decided to come on air.
The love of the nation.
Dragged in, kicking and screaming. Not my decision.
Really not my decision. I thought you might be, but actually... And you've got your radio voice on and everything.
I don't have a radio voice. It's just a voice.
That's very...
Can I say from the outset, this is a horrific idea. Okay. I had no hand or part in the planning of this. I don't want to be involved in this. I thought I was nearly out the door. Well, give me a bottle of wine. Kick my arse out the door. Survived unscathed. And now I'm here to be humiliated in the grand tradition of OTB leaving exactly. gigs.
Normal service will resume in just a little while, but for the next few minutes,
who's producing this?
Please do indulge us, because we do want to mark JP's departure in appropriate fashion. He has been the most integral part of this show over the last 5.5 years. And you know it's a big deal when the big dog, Jer Gilroy, has come into studio
12 and a half hours after the last time I was here today.
On a Thursday? Have you come up with anything decent in the last 12 and a half hours?
Nothing.
This a performance review?
Yeah.
Is it?
Okay. Actually, this is just a very public humiliation of you, JP.
I did realise, JP, that this is our opportunity to get you to live power rank the most annoying off the ball presenters. Oof. Starting with the most annoying. Joe hasn't said a word. He's here, by the way.
I think we know where to start, JP, because, like, you know, you worked with the most egotistical man in radio.
Nathan, you're sitting
Am I going to say Ray Foley or Joe Malloy?
Hey,
what do you think?
Boom, no comment.
Joe Malloy, good evening.
Good evening. Hello, everyone. Hello, JP.
This is actually terrible because I sent Joe a very sweetly composed text message earlier and I really didn't think I'd have to face the man
again.
So this is very awkward.
This is
like the
JP
second
I,
date. It's very
awkward. Earlier on, JP and I exchanged words that, frankly, we couldn't say to each other with eye contact. It was strictly, I can type this into a screen. So
I can't quit
now
you,
to
man.
Be forced to confront him is, it is awkward, JP.
Read out the text. Read out the text. That's exactly
what
I
think.
That's exactly what the audience is demanding. They demand that you read out the text.
He can't, because it's so complimentary of him that he would end up looking like a dick, so he can't.
they're also far too long. I mean, we've
got
our heart
of
and
time.
Soul into these text messages. It is a sad day, though, I think we can all agree. A man with the finest work ethic, I think, in show business departs the scene. So I guess that's the reason we're making such a big deal is I think it's safe to say very few worked harder than JP across the last 5.5 years.
Some of the best nights that we've ever had have been at road shows where we've had some of the most famous people in the world coming and telling us their truths. And Joe and Nathan would have made the Keane and Neville thing look completely effortless on the screen and on the stage and for everybody who was at the room that night. But I know exactly the amount of work that went into making it such a tremendous visual extravaganza, making it feel like it was an event worthy of the venue, which before that, like, we used to do some events and they were good and they were a bit haphazard and we would, by the seat of our pants, we would pull them off because, sometimes we were having a few drinks before the show, you know? That all stopped when JP arrived.
Oh, no, not on my say-so. This is all worryingly nice stuff, so the downside to this is going to be massive. So when does that kick in?
I know the listeners might think the presenters are egotistical maniacs and never have doubts, but there might be times where presenters do have doubts and JP was always there to reassure you, like that night of Keane Neville where, let's be honest, Joe, we might have walked off stage and the first thing was a deep breath and a whew, and JP went, thought that was good.
Well, I wasn't in the firing line. I mean, you guys were faced with the runaway train that is Roy Keane in full Angel of Death mode. So that was like one of the most exciting nights I've ever been involved with in radio. In fact, probably the most exciting. That spread into the wee small hours in terms of legal, tying up loose ends and whatnot after it. But
Just because you're gone doesn't mean you have to sell everything.
I didn't get both barrels and more like you guys did, so I had a lot of sympathy for you that night.
Surely dealing with Keane wasn't as stressful as dealing with Ronan O'Gara at a roadshow.
The mercurial Ronan O'Gara, yeah. A latecomer often. Twice at least he showed up about half an hour in.
Now, one time wasn't there like a...
Can I just say, this is desperate stuff. People listen to this are like, who is this guy and why is he on the radio? Well, actually, no, it's perfectly evident why he has not been on the radio for the last 5.5 years.
It's a free
Nobody
ad.
Wants this, but
it's
anyway.
It's a free ad for your new show. It's the last time that's ever going to happen.
What time is the new show on?
Two, half four. Wow, today.
2.5 hours. How many songs per hour?
Oof, at least 8.
When's it starting, JP? It must be next week, is it? Because you're leaving today. So it must be starting next
week,
right?
Very soon.
Oh, you've got a month playing golf. What is that? You're not starting for another month.
We're brainstorming.
I was a big fan of the Ray Foley show. Back, I mean, you know, younger man than you are, JP. So I was a listener. I think back when you even did The Blast late at night, was it like 10 o'clock?
10 to midnight,
to midnight. And then when we worked together in Today FM back in the day, and you had a segment, JP, that I always loved on a Friday, Feedback with JP.
Oh no.
So JP, I don't know if this is going to come back and I've ruined it and you thought that the listeners would have forgot, right? And this is going to be your big return on the Monday.
Oh, it'll be happening. We will be flogging all those dead horses.
You see, I don't know in current cancel culture the way it worked whether you'll quite get away with talking about Ryan Tuberty the way you once did back then. There might be a bit of a backlash. But I have come up with something for tonight's show called Feedback for JP.
Ooh, right.
And we've been talking.
So
we've been talking, JP, to some of your favourite guests and analysts. And they've got a little message for you.
Oh, God.
Hello, JP. It's John here. Just first of all, wish you all the best in your new appointment. And I'd like to thank you for all the help you've given me over the years on Off the Ball. So sorry to hear you're leaving. I'm sure everybody else is. You'll be a big loss to the radio. But for the future, happy, healthy future to you and your family.
JP, you're gone. You're leaving us. Your next offer must be off the charts if you're leaving that team behind. Thanks a lot for the last good few years. It's been a pleasure. Thanks for hand-holding, guidance. Helped me take my foot out of my mouth once or twice. And in honour, I grew this goatee for you. Well, that and wanted to be a bit more like Dan McFarland. Anyway, I hope the next gig is a winner for you. Be well.
Hi, JP. Well, sad to hear that you're leaving News Talk. Hope you're on to bigger, brighter and greater things. Hope you have a fantastic and successful time. And well, I thought I'd show you the outside things. You only ever see inside and downstairs in the house. I do get outside now and again. But it's been great working with you. It'll be odd not to hear your voice every week. And just in simple terms, have a great one. Enjoy it. And I hope we get a chance to meet again and work again.
JP, well, you don't think of me as a complainer over the years, but I'm on now because I'm These are confusing and difficult times we all live in. You know that. The listeners know that. Yet you've added to the fractured, unhappy nature of our existence. Not only by leaving, but by not making it clear what's going on. So really, this is just a message to say, what the f***?
Hi, JP. Keith Wood here. Just saying congratulations on your move. I don't know where you're going yet, but I'm presuming it's a good thing for you. I've really enjoyed all the direction and support over the years, and I hope you go on to better and greater things. Congratulations again.
You're leaving Off the Ball. I can't believe it. I really, really cannot believe that you're leaving. I'm going to miss those little texts that you send me in the afternoon. Can you do it? If you've got 1% chance of not doing it, don't say yes. Those stressful little phone calls that you give me when you want me on the show. But I am going to miss you. I'm going to miss those calls. 5.5 years ago in 2016 when we both joined Off the Ball together. Can you believe it? 5.5 years ago. How you've hung on this long, I do not know. Where do I start? How you manage me, I don't know. I really do not know how you manage me, especially around Christmas time. You know, those late nights occasionally that I would have had and maybe arriving in late and you were getting stressed about me arriving and things like that and the phone calls I've had to get in to do a morning pre-record. The editing king, of course, that you are. I'll still always, always love you for the time that I was interviewing Gordon Taylor from the PFA and I managed to call him Graham on a couple of occasions. The editing chief himself, JP, got it edited out for me, so fair play to you. I appreciate that. But I don't know, mate. You're going back with your old pal Ray Foley here as well. He was always your first love. I know that. I know you said that you love me, but it was always Ray. You always wanted to go back to him. So I just wanted to wish you all the best.
Oh, Kev.
Oh, never go back out.
You got the man to show up. Well, bloody hell.
God, he's been in
negotiations for the last 2 weeks.
Yes. Those snarky little texts you've been sending him all over the years. Just, if there's 1% chance, don't say yes.
That is a thing. I mean, there's been many an evening where we've had Kev 100% locked in. And it turns out it was actually only 99 and JP would have to sort someone out in the space of about 6 minutes.
That's the gift that somebody else can now look after.
I think we can see from that video, and for anyone who's listening in on the radio, Kilbane is basically sass.
In a bar?
Like he's in the Playboy mansion.
In a living room?
He's with a bottle of Jameson beside him.
And a few fingers of whiskey in that.
He's traded up from the Drambuie that's usually in the background. So.
Right.
Yeah. That was amazing. That's a fair play to everyone. I'm going to have to text a lot of people afterwards to say thank you. That's very touching.
I mean, we obviously pay all those people to come on off the
ball. They're contracted. So.
Yeah. Exactly.
Brian O'Driscoll's desperately scrambling to remember, who's JP again?
Which one's he?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Which one's he? Oh, you did good. Well done.
Thanks.
Well done.
Oh, is this over?
No, you've got to power rank the most annoying presenters. Oh. Come on.
No, I'm not going to do that. Jesus.
I was tempted.
No, I'm not going to do that. I mean, have I done that privately? Yes.
Tempted. What was the highlight, JP? What was the highlight then?
The highlight was the people. The people. I mean, genuinely, as cheesy and as, you know, I'm not a very nice person, so this is hard to do, but genuinely, and I've said this on any number of goodbye calls across the last couple of weeks, but the people are exceptional. Anyone listen to this, you got the pleasure of seeing the kind of the product of all the work that goes on behind the scenes, but the people here are incredible to work with. I'll miss them massively. I'll miss the people you never see, the likes of Paul Murnoch, Catherine, Arthur, Kean outside, all those people. They don't get much of a shout out, but they're absolutely essential. So it's been my pleasure to work with them really closely as the shows have gone out, and I've lent on them. I was never a natural fit necessarily on the show, so anyone who comes after me is going to absolutely blow the bloody doors off. So it's only onwards and upwards, I would say.
You mean there were sometimes questions of the depth of JP's knowledge of the, you know, pre-season tournaments in the GAA. But you are a fountain of knowledge when it comes to golf.
No.
Are you going to join Golf Weekly?
Oof, is that door open?
Well, part of your leaving present is a free subscription to Golf Weekly Patreon.
Wow.
Just so you can get
excellent.
Some
wow.
That is like the Rolex watch.
Goodness on a weekly basis.
Sweet. My sports knowledge has remained. I've sort of been immune to gathering sports knowledge in the 5.5 years I've been on the show. So, I've been around it, but I haven't quite assumed all that knowledge.
In terms of the most boring radio of all time, talking about someone's golf handicap is right up there, but clearly your commitment level is shown by the fact that I think when you started you were clearly a far better golfer than Joe Malloy, yet that has changed somewhat. Is that fair to say, Joe? No, I think your handicap is quite a bit better than JP's now.
Well, listen.
Look at that steely look in his eye. Now he's getting competitive. Bloody
hell. The man is... he has no time for golf. He's what were your hours, JP? 10 a.m. to midnight?
About
generally
that,
on a good
and
week?
More, and more, yeah. Always a pleasure. All the way through.
Now we're getting there. Now we're getting there. We obviously had some big names there. Some of the biggest names in world sport paying tribute. One of them, though, wasn't just satisfied with the little few words of niceties. One of them wanted to pay proper, old-fashioned Irish tribute to a great man in JP Gilbourne.
Usually on a night out, I would usually sing a song anyway at the end of a night. And I just tried to rejig the words of one of my favorite songs. So here goes, I'll sing this JP just for you. Good luck with everything. Here goes. Dear Jer, I write this note to you to tell you of me plight. I am just sick of working with this shower of shite. My body is all black and blue, my face a deathly grey. And I write this note to say why JP's not at work today. While working on the second floor, some shite I had to clear. Now to throw it down from such a height was not a good idea. The foreman Barry wasn't pleased, he'd been an awkward sod. He said I'd have to cart it down a ladder on a hod. Now shifting all this shite by hand, it was so very slow. So I hoisted up a barrel and secured the rope below. But in me haste to do the job, I was too blind to see that a barrel with Malloy and Murphy was heavier than me. So when I untied the rope, the barrel fell like lead, and clinging tightly to the rope, I started up instead. Well, I shot up like a rocket, till to my dismay I found that halfway up I met the bloody barrel coming down. Well, the barrel broke me shoulder as to the ground it sped, and when I reached the top, I banged the pulley with me head. I clung on tight, though none was shocked from this almighty blow, and the shower of shite spilt 4 floors below. Now when the shite had fallen from the barrel to the floor, I then outweighed the barrel and so started down once more. Still clinging tightly to the rope, I sped towards the ground, and I landed on all the shite that was all scattered round. Well, I lay there moaning on the ground, I thought I'd passed the worst. When the barrel hit the pulley wheel and then the bottom burst, well, a shower of shite rained down on me, I hadn't got a hope. As I lay there moaning on the ground, I let go of the bloody rope. Well, the barrel then being heavier, it started down once more and landed right across me as I lay upon the floor. Well, it broke 3 ribs in my left arm, and I can only say that I hope you'll understand why JP's not at work again. JP, all the very best. Thank you for everything you've done to me, Sláinte.
Come on, Kev.
Down at one.
Kevin Kilbourne.
I am definitely not worthy. That was some stamina from the big man. I mean, that was what? Jesus. 4 minutes or something. Bloody hell.
Five and a half years, JP, and your final moments are the peak.
I think radio complete. Done.
To say how things are going downhill quickly after your departure, Kevin sent me that. Obviously, he's in Canada, so there's a time difference. So he sent it to me in the middle of the night, and I was awake at about 7:15, half watching it, one eye open, and sent it on to the production team. So Arthur, who's stepping into your role at the moment, just sent me a message after through saying, "Have you listened to this in full? Is it okay?" Which I was going, "Not really."
It's a bit of blue for the dads. It's fine. It's grand.
Wow, that was sensational. I kind of want to leave now, Joe, and see what we could get from Kilbourne.
That's the most prepared he's ever been for anything he's ever done on the show. That's incredible. That's the ringtone. Jesus.
Absolutely. Great voice as well. Oh, I've only ever heard him over a drunken din. That was beautiful.
Time for an ad break nearly, I would say, lads, is it?
There's no topping that at all. I think the entire nation is a bit shell-shocked.
Leave on a high.
Exactly. Yeah. Go out on that. JP, thank you for everything.
Nathan, yeah. It's been my privilege.
OTB Hall of Famer.
Chair, a privilege as well. And Joe, and everyone else. Like, I'm not worthy of this at all, and I'm sorry that people listening and watching had to stick through this, but
I think Kevin Kilbourne made it worth their while.
He did. That was worth the admission fee alone.
Ladies and gentlemen, JP Gilbourne.
Woo!
Well done, JP.
Service will resume right after these.
Off the Ball on News Talk.